In this video, I will try to cover some of the concepts on which maps of M1 vectors are based on. There are various types of maps, and I will try to show how to find the position vector of a specific particle after a certain time duration, and how to find the position at which two particles meet. So suppose we have a point here initially. So all the positions are usually measured from origin. So the initial position are denoted by a notation R0. So after a certain time duration, the particle has moved to a different position. This is your second position. So the displacement here is Vt. So if we need to find the final position here from the origin, suppose this is R, the formula for finding the final position is R0 plus Vt. Here R0 is the initial position and V is the velocity, and it has to be constant throughout the whole time, and R denotes the final position. Okay, so suppose we have a particle P. The initial position of a particle is -3i plus 3j. I here denotes the x-axis, the direction, and y is represented by j. So the particle is moving at a velocity of, suppose, 4i plus 2j. So if the question asks that what is the final position of P after t second, you need to find R0 plus Vt. So -3i plus 3j plus velocity is 4i plus 2j into time. You can keep your answer in this form, but it's always better to write the I coordinate and the j coordinate separately. So if we multiply this time with the two terms, then 4ti 2tj. So we have two coordinates of I. So by combining these two terms, we will get -3 plus 4ti. Similarly, we have two terms of j. So if we combine this, so 3 plus 2tj. So this is your final position of particle P after t second. So suppose if you need to know where particle P is after 4 seconds, just put the value of t in this equation. So 4 is a 12y, 4 is a 8j. So the answer is 9i plus 11j. So the particle P is at this position after 4 seconds. So this will be 4, 4, 16. So this is 13i plus 11j. Okay, so for example, we have two points, particle P and particle Q. R0 is the initial position, V is the final, V is the velocity. So using the formula, R equals R0 plus Vt, we can find the final position of P after t second. So -3 plus 4ti plus 3 plus 2tj. And similarly, we can find the final position of Q after t second. That will be -4 plus 5ti 4 plus tj. Okay, so if we need to show that particle P and Q has met at a certain point, and we need to find that specific position at which the two particle meets, that is intersecting position. Okay, to show that the two particle has met at a certain point, we need to find the time at which the two particle meet at a certain point. So suppose This is your I coordinate for particle P, and that's your I coordinate for particle Q. So if we equate the I coordinate of both the terms, so by solving this, we will get that tan equals to 1. Similarly, if we use the J coordinates, that is 3 plus 2t equals 4 plus t, here you can see that tan equals to 1. So since both the time, the value of time from the I coordinate and the J coordinate is equal, it means particle P and Q has met. If the two time values of the time are different, it is not proved that the particle has met. So after proving that the two particle has met, we can find the position of intersection. So to find the position of intersection, all you need to do is just put the value of time, which is t equals to 1 here, in any one of the equations. So suppose we are using equation of particle P. So if time equals to 1, this becomes 3 plus 2j. So the intersecting point is I plus 5j.